musical about an individual going about making her favourite dreams come true. With all the challenges in life, it's not surprising that some of us, if not all of us, fail to make our dreams come true. Then someday, when it's too late, we regret not doing so. We hope that our show is a reminder to all, young and old, that it's never too late to make your dream come true. Natya Bollywood sessions and shows have been operating successfully since November 2006. Starting off as simply a dancing teaching school, it then conducted Bollywood dancing shows. After many successful sessions and shows, Natya Bollywood decided it's time to pull together all its current talent and put on a show for audiences far and wide, displaying to all our ability to put on an entertaining stage show. There are numerous talents out there, either individuals or groups, and during the making of this production, Natya Bollywood has recognised the wide range of talent it has amongst its own students, crew, and special guests. Natya Bollywood aims to promote as much upcoming local talent as possible. This show is the first of its kind by any Bollywood dance school in Melbourne. It's been created and conducted by Natya Bollywood and performed by its students, both adults and kids, and supported by Poison, the hip hop group. We are now ready to by lighting the lamp, and I'm with your permission, the founder and director of Natya Bollywood, to come on stage and light the lamp.
Thank you. journey can be an amazing adventure, whether it's one you encountered unexpectedly or you dreamt of it as a goal to accomplish. And if you did choose a goal from a dream, wouldn't it be nice if you could all have our dreams come true? Well, welcome to the story of Diya, a talented young Indian girl who is very passionate to pursue her dancing dreams in the face of all obstacles and objections. She believes life is all about dancing and having fun. A month ago, Diya and her widowed mother migrated from India to Melbourne. Will Diya be able to convince everyone and pursue her Bollywood dancing dreams in Melbourne? Is life truly all about dancing and having fun? Let us find out.
Oi, Diya, don't forget about school tomorrow. Make sure you have your bag and clothes ready.
Will they teach dancing at the school tomorrow?
This is not India, darling. There won't be any dance teaching here. Most definitely not the kind of dancing you've been learning.
But I don't want to go to the school.
Now, don't say things like that. You just be ready, all right? I didn't work so hard in this unknown country to find you a school just to have you rebel against going. Dancing is not everything. You need a good education and a good job, and dancing all day will not be getting you anywhere.
Mom, I didn't say dancing is everything. I can get a good education and do dancing at the same time.
Well, you won't have time to do your education and dancing. Your subjects are going to get tougher now. You really should consider what job you want to do in the future, what uni you must get into to get that job, then what subjects you must learn now at school. This is more important than your dreams of just dancing. Now don't argue with me, eat your dinner and go to sleep.
Diya reluctantly gulps down her dinner and suddenly goes to bed. In her sleep, she dreams about her childhood days in India, dancing with her little friends. The next morning, mother takes Thea to school to meet the principal and take her to her first class.
Good morning, Mr. Carmichael.
Yes, come in.
My name is Mrs. Chalker, and I would like to join Thea to join our meeting.
Ah, yes, yes, take a seat. So, you're enrolled in year 10. Let's see, you'll be in class 10A.
Mr. Carmichael?
Yes?
Are there any dance classes in the school?
Are there what?
Is there a teacher that teaches dancing in the school?
Why the devil's name would there be such a teacher or class in this fine school? What a preposterous question to ask. You may think to get a top-class education to secure a fine career, not to be wasting your time and ours, is getting around to areas such as dancing. Now, let me not hear the word dancing for you ever again. Is it understood?
Yes, Mr.
Carmichael. Okay, now, hold me to your classroom. Ms. Parker, this is Thea, a new student. Students, please make Thea feel welcome.
Thea, please take your seat quickly. The class is nearly finished up. Now, class, before the bell rings, let me remind you of the homework you must complete this week.
Indie Spawn puts on her CD player and dances to her favorite song, Dora Ray. But isn't this place really quiet and empty? Or could they be surprised?
Hey, no.
Thank you.
Back at home, Thea is itching to ask her mom about why she doesn't support her dad's games anymore.
Mom, why don't you like my dad's game?
Thea, I didn't say I didn't like dad's game anymore. I said it's not practical to do dad's game anymore. A far more important thing is to study than just dancing. And besides,
this place is
not in India. Nobody teaches while you're dancing at school, Thea.
But Mom, maybe I can change that. I can teach what I have already learned and start my own dance.
That's cool. Now, will you shut up? You're going too far. You haven't even finished your dance education yet. And you think you're an expert at teaching someone? What is wrong with you?
Mom, I can teach what I know so far, and then someday I'm going to finish up the rest of my dance education and come back and keep dancing.
So wait a minute. Your future job is to be a dance teacher? Are you out of your mind? Is that why I'm sending you to such a fine and expensive school? So you can come out and become a dance teacher? Oh my goodness. How can I make them understand about life, reality, and dream?
Dreams can't come true, you know, Mom.
I'm not talking about dreams coming true. I'm talking to make them understand that your dream is not worth coming true.
Mom, this is so mean.
Anyway, this child is going to do my head in. Listen, I don't like him when he was more fun and excitement, but that was when Daddy was around. Darling, since Daddy has gone and we've moved away from our family and friends, all I can do now is make sure you get a good education, a better life than me. Look at me. Do you want to end up like me, uneducated and lonely? Do you?
Mom, I don't mean to upset you, but I don't know why, but I can't get this desire of dancing out of me. Please, if you take this desire to dance out of me, then I'll be able to do anything you want me to do.
Darling, it's not your fault. You can't help the blood that is running your veins.
What do you mean, Mom?
Well, I was a popular dancer too in my younger days.
What? Mom? How can you never do this?
Well, your dad didn't approve me of dancing and wanted me to be a housewife. But I agreed to do this on the condition that if we have a daughter, that she must be allowed to learn to dance if she wants to. And Daddy agreed. However, Daddy did not have her daughter so soon, leaving me a housewife to be Daddy and Mom.
Mom, you can dance?
What? Of course I can dance. You think the only one that can dance is it? Don't forget the routine you've got.
Mom, it's all that I can do to you being able to dance.
I was young once too, you know. A gorgeous young lady and a fine dancer. I was on a college day. What else do you think your daddy was chasing, huh? Oh, so you think I can't dance, huh? Well, let me show you my dance.
Yeah.
Struggling like this. Please take me seriously, darling. Life is not all about dancing. If you can balance education and dancing, well, then go for it, okay?
Okay.
Come, let's go to bed.
Next morning at school, Thea finds that her secret is out.
Hey, Thea, so we hear that you like dancing.
So it's true? Maybe it is, or maybe it isn't. What does it do?
Just a hang
on, all right. Look at that.
So, dear, what do you call this dancing? We haven't seen anything like that before. You all saw me dancing?
As much as we don't know what you were dancing to. Really good. What language was that?
Do you mind dancing with Scooby?
Yeah.
But we still don't know what style of dancing that is.
What?
Oh my goodness, Bollywood dancing! Haven't you heard about Bollywood dancing?
No, this is Australia, love. You want Latin?
Jazz?
Well, this is the first one. Well, I'm going to change that. It's truly unfair to the people of Australia to be deprived of Bollywood dancing.
Yeah, well, good luck to you, my dear. This is Hattie Lee Pye. You'll be lucky to get through your subjects like when I've had time for dancing.
Well, if I had all your help, I could bring Bollywood dancing to you in Australia.
Well,
I could teach you Bollywood dancing.
Whoa, hold your horses, young lady. That dance looks pretty girly, and besides, it's your language and from your country. Best you teach your people, don't you think?
No, you see, this is so untrue. Bollywood dancing is for anybody and everybody. Anyone can do it for fun. For those who want to take it further, well, they can take it seriously. It's so much more fun than being up in the wee hours of the morning and busting your jobs to pray and lose our gym.
No, hang on, you see. Some of us have goals and aspirations, you know. We want to get to the Olympics and compete. Besides, it looks too girly for us clubs to dance to.
Oh my goodness! Bollywood is for any gender and any age group!
Yeah, but what we saw yesterday from you was so girly. How do you expect the boys to dance to that?
Oh, there are dances for boys too!
There are?
Yes, there are. Yes, there are Bollywood dances for boys. So, do you know how to dance to Mehbooba?
Yes.
Check it out now.
ballroom dancing if Alex likes it, then we want to pay him to dance.
Tomorrow lunchtime, and I'll be there to teach you your first dance. Don't be scared, I'll take it really slowly. You will love it.
During lunchtime, Thea hurriedly prepares the meeting room to teach her classmates their first Bollywood dance. Wonder how this will turn out.
Hey guys, thank you so much for coming this class.
How much more lunchtime do you expect to spend on dancing?
Guys, come on, this is quite a big commitment. I mean, if you're not keen to put the hard yards in, then I might as well not bother teaching at all.
Yeah, well, we can't do this all the time. People are bound to find out what happens.
No one is going to laugh at you. Did you even laugh at us? Right? No, yeah. Well, then once I'm finished with teaching you, no one is going to laugh at you, okay? The song I'm teaching you today is from the movie Jumping Men, meaning When We Met. I promise to show you the entire movie one day. The song itself is called Moja Hai Moja, which means fun and frolic. So let's start now!
While Dia excitedly starts teaching her classmates how to dance, Alex happens to walk by and spot all the commotion. Alex soon sees Dia's excitement turning into desperation as the classmates become a whole lot complicated to teach than Dia anticipated.
Now come on guys, take me seriously please. It's not like you all don't know how to dance at all, so why are you making it so hard for me?
Man, you're making it sound like it's a piece of cake. It's not easy, you know. Acting and dancing, but hey, you understand the words, so it's easy for you to remember what I'm saying.
Yes, but I don't worry about the meaning too much now, okay? Just try to remember what Mookum says.
Can I be of some assistance?
Yeah, if you can help, that would be great.
Okay boys, you ready to spend it?
Yeah, you know, let's do it.
school, there was one.
What was all that about? How did all this happen? And why? All she knows is that she's very happy.
Next day, whilst walking to the classroom,
Pierre's eyes glanced at a small yet attractive poster pinned to the bulletin board. It reads, "Dance Spell Competition 2008. Mia quickly gets a brilliant idea and decides to share it with her mates.
Guys, did you see that dance competition poster on the bulletin board?
Yep. What is it? And where on the board?
On the bulletin board, back there.
Yeah, that would be right. So what's the big deal?
I'm surprised that's not allowed there. Positive when the principal finds out he's going to chuck a fit.
But why? It's such a good thing. I have a really cool idea that I need you guys to agree on, please.
What? Are you out of your mind? We already told you about the principal. And besides, what kind of dance do you expect us to do there? Bollywood?
Yes!
Dear, we barely know any Bollywood dancing, and you can't expect us to be ready for competition.
Yeah, seriously, dear, don't you think you're expecting a bit much of us? And besides, I don't think there's a segment on there for Bollywood dancing as part of the comp.
Well, it doesn't specifically say it's a comp for a specific dance. So we can do whatever dance style you choose as long as a good entertaining dance.
Hey, dear, I'm serious about Mr. Carmichael. If he finds out that we're part of this competition, he will have us all expelled.
But how can he do that? The poster is in the school grounds.
Why don't we take a risk and show him what he should really find out? What do you mean?
Well, if we dance well and we win the competition, then I think the prize money should go to the school. And then perhaps the principal will finally realize the worth of dancing.
Fine. How are you?
Good, thanks.
That's good.
Alex?
Yeah?
Could I ask you a favor, please?
What is it?
You see, there's a dance school competition coming up, and I was just wondering perhaps having my classmate put together a Bollywood dance routine to compete, and I would love it if you could be a part of the competition with us. Like, I know it's tough playing in school policy and we could all get into trouble and all, but this is such a wonderful opportunity and you are such a good dancer.
Yeah, good.
And I wouldn't want your fabulous talent wasted away. And did you just say yes?
Yes, I'm in.
Oh my god, you're amazing. Thank you so much.
I think you're best to be quiet about this. Like you said, you could get into trouble.
Oh yes, sorry.
So, when does rehearsal start and what are we dancing to?
Is Dia's dream suddenly coming true? Or is there more to this?
Guys, look who we have to help us in the competition.
Cool.
Thanks, Alex.
No worries. Okay, so Melia, why don't we get started?
Let you and me do the moves, and then you lot copy us.
That's great. See you all at the next lesson.
Thank you so much, Alex. I don't know why I went to the cave when I'm not around.
It's okay.
Don't mention it. I'm glad I found you.
Wait a minute. Did you say you would like to find the app? Oh, fine. Looks like this will find love.
Thank you. Now, ladies and gentlemen, the last performance for the evening. We're going to need you to cast away all your expectations so far about dancing, because the dance you're about to see is nothing like you've ever seen before. It's colourful, it's dramatic, it's acting and dancing all in one, and it's called Bollywood Dancing, brought to you by the students of Hathaway High. Ladies and gentlemen, please make them welcome. each of the five schools that competed today.
Third prize
goes to Southmore High! Now the second prize goes to... Oh, wait a minute, the judges want me to read something here. This decision was very difficult, and the second prize winner lost out by just 1 point. The second prize winner is... Haddingley High!
That means the winner goes 4 points in a row
by just 1 point only are the students from Summersville High.
Congratulate Haddingley High for a damn good competition. Well done, guys.
Oh, that was great. And how do you feel about your performance?
Just over the moon. We wanted to win, however. I think for the little time we got to put our dance together and the very little support we had, coming this far is truly amazing. Thank you to my wonderful troupe for believing in themselves.
Well, that's all for us, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you to all the schools that competed. We'll see you back next year for another ringer of the competition.
Dia and Alex, that was awesome. We can't believe we came second even.
You guys were simply amazing. Thank you so much for everything, Alex.
You guys are welcome. I had a brilliant time working with you all.
And now let's hope that Mr. Carmichael is just as happy.
Next day during morning class, Dia, Alex and the four classmates are asked to go to the principal's office. This can only mean trouble.
So you think you can dance, eh? You think you can just enter my school into competition and go up and dance your dance on stage without my permission? What were you thinking? How dare you? I had a call from the people in the competition. It seems you guys came second, and the school will be receiving the prize money for that. Well, I guess you're not going to dance after all. All right, Dia, I guess you proved your point. Dancing does seem to mean a lot to you. You managed to find others like yourself and do good with that too, so well done.
Mr. Coleman, thank you so much.
Yes, and we're looking to having a dance taught at the school next term onwards, okay?
Oh my goodness, thank you so much, Mr. Coleman.
Yeah, now, before you get all excited, reckon you can teach an oldie like me a bit of Bollywood? I do like my 70s music, and I'm sure you can do a few moves.
Oh, yes, Mr. Coleman. We have the perfect dance for you. You ready?
Ready as I'll ever be. What are we doing?
Archkira, in a night like tonight, I'll show you the guy moves, but the girls start this one first.
All right, let's do it.
Thank you.
Show, if you believe in your dream strong enough, you can definitely make your dreams come true.
Now, you guys ready to predict the finale?
Yes, we are.
All right, I'm going to announce you all in a second. Break the leg.
Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for being here today and showing your support to wonderful children, our students. It's with great pride to introduce to you our last performance for the evening. It's been a tough journey for them over the principal of the school. I look forward to clearing their path for the future, making their journey easier. The dance the students will present to you is very colourful and tributary of the country where Bollywood comes from, India. And we'll bring that to us here in Australia. Let's give our big round of applause for the last dance tonight to a song named Es Rangila, Colourful Country.
Oh,
you put your mind to it, your dreams can certainly come true. Until next time, wish you a happy dream journey.
Gone too fast. For all that work we've done, it's actually gone quite quickly. And
each and every one of you means so much to me, and as a result, you've got the entertainment that you've got tonight. Did you like it?
Yeah!
Costume manager, Don Smith, please take a seat. Don has been costume workshops, taking orders, and finally telling her to go, because she's handled all these costumes by herself in the end, which is the first time ever, I think, and you've done a great job. Thank you, darling.
Yummy food from Corona. Timeless cuisine.
तो दिल दीवाने हैं, दिन जो सुहाने हैं, तो दिल दीवाने हैं,
दिन जो सुहाने हैं, तो दिल दीवाने
हैं। हे ये फिजाएं, हे सुन लो
the way it is over and the heart.